Whoa. I was gonna say, who's over here? Hey everybody, my name is Cayden, and welcome to Mass Effect Andromeda. I've actually had this game for a little over a week. I was testing it out. There were some bugs, but they've been fixed, like the Corsair utility bug. You had to uninstall Corsair in order to play the game, which is kind of weird, but that's been fixed. So, let's go ahead and jump right into a new game. Let's go ahead and customize the character. Let's see, I just jumped right in real quick. I did the generic person. I didn't customize anything. So this is going to be a new experience for the both, for all of us. Alright, we get to choose our gender. Alright. Let's choose male. Alright. Customize appearance. Choose from a variety of preset appearances or fully customize the character's look. Alright, use the default appearance of a writer. This option does not allow any visual customization. Let's go with custom appearance. Alright, so head one. Okay, changing the hair too. Okay. Alright, I think I can change the hair here. So let's just go for the head. No. Got that goatee going on. Got kind of my complexion. Maybe he's a little darker than me. I'm kind of white. Alright, let's go with... I gotta look at myself, hold on. He's too much of an oval shape. No. No. I think it was... Is it six? It was six. I think that's the closest, maybe? I don't know. I'm not good at customizing my face. Oh, okay, so there's... Can I just do that? No, okay. Skin tone. Is this lighter? Why am I Asian now? Okay, that's darker. I'm white. Okay. Brows are fine. Cheeks. Cheek height. I don't really see a difference. Okay, I see it. A little bit. No, I do not have a fat cheeks. Alright, then cheekbone width. Eh. No, no. Again, I don't have fat cheeks. There we go. Chin looks fine. Eyes. Eye width. Whoa. Hey. My eyes aren't that close together. Eye depth? What is... Oh. Okay, big eyes. Eye height. Sure. Mouth. Again, I still look Asian. Why do I look Asian? Lip thickness? Mouth depth? No. Nose. I mean, the eyes still look like they're really Asian eyes. Anyway, let's go with the hair. Hairstyle. I doubt they're gonna have my hairstyle. The shaved sides. Actually, you know what? That may be closest to my hairstyle. Actually, no, that looks kind of Hispanic, not Asian. Maybe I need to go a little lighter. Hair color is going to be dark brown. Yes. Facial hair type is going to be... Oh, yeah. Full and rugged. These are all, like... Eh. Was it one? No. Okay, so that's all we get for choices. Wait, what is this? No. 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 Alright, so this one it is. It's, I guess, the closest one. The eyes. I have kind of hazel eyes. I'm not really sure where that is on the scale. Sure, why not? The inner eye? Oh, that's weird. Okay, I'm just gonna leave it like that. That's cool. Makeup, no thanks. Scar tissue, no. Alright, skin tone, it's the lightest. Okay, so apparently I can't do okay, so this is gonna have to do for my character. You can't really customize it all the way. And he is a N47H4N. That's his rank. Anyway, let's go ahead and just jump right back in. Let's go ahead and select. Okay. Oh, tattoo. Tattoo design. Is it gonna be on his face? Oh, it said it is on his face. I don't have any tattoos on my face. That looks weird. Actually, that looks kind of decent right there. Is it on this side? Eh. I'd rather have it on my right side. There we go. Tattoo color is going to be... Just do red. Why not? Looks kind of cool. All right. Select. Confirm. This is us. Our Asian kind of looking, Asian Hispanic kind of looking self. Because we can't go full on white. Like me. All right. Choose training. Choose the special training writer received in the Milky Way before joining the Andromeda Initiative. This training determines what power you will have from the start and what skills you will gain early access to. Current skill training is security. Ooh, technician. As technician in the Systems Alliance military, you learned to operate drones and hack enemy systems. Starting power is overload. Unleash an electrostatic discharge that deals high damage to shields and synthetic enemies. Can chain to multiple targets. Alright. Unlock skills. Invasion. Hack into your opponent's armor and weapons, infecting them with a computer virus to weaken their defenses and even spread to nearby foes. Team support. Develop specialized technology to bolster the survivability of your entire squad. Huh. What is a concussive shot? Okay. Fires a heat-seeking high-impact round to knock down opponents. Unlocked skills. Turbocharge grants a massive short-term boost to weapon fire rate and thermal clip efficiency. And combat efficiency or combat fitness is grants increased durability and the option to carry more of weapons into battle. Biotic. You were effectively designed biotic during the Alliance military tenure, assisting your court's with ability to control mass effect fields. Interesting. Let's actually just go with technician. That looks, I like technology. That sounds pretty cool. Confirm and start the game. Let's go ahead and go with hardcore. Would you like to start the game? Start game. Start game. There we go. And here are the opening credits.
Every great moment in our history began with a dream. Each bold leap forward was achieved by those willing to do anything to attain it. We are, all of us, leaving behind families, homes, the very birthplace of our species. Some for discovery, to see the unknown. Others for a new start. But today, whatever our reasons, we take the first steps toward a new future for humanity. Today, we begin to make our dream reality.
It looks so nice. Wow. In the year 2185, humanity lives in a golden era of interstellar travel. Our discovery of ancient alien ruins on Mars propelled our understanding of science and technology ahead of by thousands of years. While many enjoy the newfound freedom and challenges of exploring the Milky Way, others look to an even more distant stars. For the hundreds, thousands of adventurers seeking, it's a one-way trip. You guys can pause that if you want to read the whole thing. Apparently I read too slow. See, cryogenics. Alright, so this is where we have been sleeping for a very long time. Pretty nice organization. Oh.
We made it. Deep breaths. You're gonna wanna take it easy.
I've been taking it easy for 600 years.
Ryder, Scott, Recon Specialist, Pathfinder Mission Team.
Pathfinder Team, eh? The ones finding us a home.
Can you make it somewhere tropical? Nice, warm ocean, summer year-round?
How about we get him a cup of coffee first?
That's what you need after sleeping for 600 years, is a nice cup of coffee.
The selection process saw the Andromeda Initiative evaluate thousands of potential habitable planets within the galaxy.
Spot Rider, let's get you checked out.
Look here.
After discovering an unusually high ratio of potential candidates for Golden Worlds, the Helios Cluster was selected as our destination. Now you are a part of the first wave of ARCs arriving in Andromeda, our new home for humanity.
Makes it sound so easy, doesn't it?
See, tone choice. Tone choices help define Ryder's personality: emotional, logical, casual, and professional. I'm probably going to be a mix of probably logical and professional. We'll see what this gives us. See, this is casual. Yeah, easy is no fun. Eh, it's what we're trained for. That's more something I would say.
Even if it isn't, we'll be ready.
I hope so.
You know something?
Word came down. The Pathfinder wants you all mission ready within the hour. Look this way.
Why the rush?
He didn't say. But something's up. Okay, everything checks out. Just one more thing before I send you on your way. Let's test your SAM implant. Sam, are you monitoring? Sam, are you online?
Yes, Dr. Tapero. Good morning, Ryder. Are you feeling well?
See, my implant. Yes, I'm very excited. Or still thawing. See, I'm not a very morning person either, so
I
still
feel
thawing.
Like a 600-year-old popsicle. I hope we packed more coffee.
Readings confirmed. Based on the levels of adenosine in your system, the neural implant is functioning properly.
Wait, adeno what?
It just means you're still shaking off your nap. No reason why we can't get you on your way.
Sounds like me in the morning.
Though you may want to hang around while we revive your sister. It always helps to see a familiar face.
I don't like the sound of that.
Very convenient, the gravity turned off right there.
What's happening? It broke
free. Just so mouse look around. All right. Report. Floating. Press Alt to look. All right, that's kind of cool.
I'm almost to the docks. Hold on.
This is Cora. I'm at the cryo bay. Brace for a reset. Everyone okay?
I think so.
What happened?
We're not sure. Sensors are scrambled. But it's good to see you're up. Feels like centuries since we spoke.
This is the Pathfinder. Mission teams continue preparations. Cora, Riders, report to the bridge.
You heard him. Let's get...
We have a problem over here. It's Sarah Ryder.
Oh, my sister.
What's
Let's
wrong?
See.
I don't know. Have to check it out.
So you got some new stuff over here. Journal or a codex. See, the Andromeda Initiative. Arc species, planet and technology. Planet and locations. Technology, ships and vehicles. Sam. Oh, that's a lot to read. Alright, so I will wait here for a second. Give you guys a minute to read this. The initiative, let's see, history's organization and personnel and persons of note in the Andromeda Initiative. Let's see, there is Brainchild, Glossary of Terms, Hard Suit, Heatsink, Flash Forge, FTL Faster Than Light, Good Game. mass accelerator, a railgun that lowers the mass of a projectile and then hurls it at a relativistic speeds. Interesting. Then we have Jen Garrison, founder of the Andromeda Initiative, and then Andromeda Initiative Launch. See, then we have Pathfinders, apparently that's what we are. Details on the missions and personal files of all Initiative Pathfinders. Rule of a Pathfinder. Pathfinders are the tip of the spear for exploring new worlds, while planetary surveying is typically a long-term, multiple-team process. The initiative found an alternative thanks to Alec Ryder's AI research on an individual equipped with the best training and technology available, and an AI partner that can run complex studies in seconds and 100 test simulations within a minute. I'm guessing that's Sam. With AI support, Pathfinders can determine within hours whether a planet is suitable for habitation and direct the Nexus as to what colonists block standards or what colonist block stands the best chance there. Okay, if I can read correctly. Pathfinders are trained to improve the viability of potential planets, initial first contact with unknown species, find suitable outpost sites, and handle any external threats before the colonist touches soil. The presence of a Pathfinder is a reassurance that a planet could be settled safely and with high expectation of success. So that is our job. No pressure, right? No, don't want console. What is that? Go away. Thank you. See, then we have Ark species, the Asari, and the humans. Oh, okay. So there's a lot here. They really give you a lot of background information. There we go. On everything in this game, apparently. Planet's location, Andromeda Galaxy, technology, tools, the Omni-Tool, cryostasis, tech and biotics, a lot. And then ships and vehicles. There we go, the Hyperion. This is what the ship you came in. Withstand rigors of nearly 2.5 million light-year voyage. FTL, 2,000 settlers, left Milky Way in 2185. So 600 years would make it 2785. The oldest people ever alive. All right, then we have journal. Prologue, Hyperion. I guess this is our quests. Report to the Hyperion Bridge. Optional check on your sister. All right. All right, so looks really nice. Right, so we have an information wall here. E to use. A little sluggish turning around. Oh, I have to hold it longer. Okay.
Hi there. I'm Gian Garson, founder of the Andromeda Initiative. I'm here to welcome you to a whole new galaxy. The good news is, the hard part's over. We're here. If you have any questions now, just ask.
Okay. That's kind of cool, the information wall right there.
Give it a second for the
process. It's a little sluggish. I think I need to...
No. Physical integrity looks good.
That sounds good. Okay. Hold.
There.
Scott.
Okay, there we go.
Is my sister okay?
Sarah's fine. Her vitals are strong. But the revival procedure was interrupted.
When can she wake up?
We don't want to rush it. Sam?
My connection to Sarah's implant was suspended. However, her pulse, respiration, and brain activity are all normal.
That sounds good.
To be on the safe side, we'll need to keep her in a low-level coma for a while, then let her body regain consciousness naturally. She'll be fine.
Glad to hear it.
Thanks, Lexi. Keep us updated.
Ryder, I'll wait for you at the door. Whenever you're ready to go.
So, Sarah Ryder.
How do you want to handle?
Okay, so there is an easier way to pull up all this stuff. Okay. The Andromeda Initiative. Sarah Ryder. Born your elder twin in the Citadel Space Station in 2163. Sarah grew up surrounded by a multitude of alien species, cultures, and histories. In her orientation interviews, she claims that... She claims this sparked her fascination with science. With informational With informal training aided by Alec Reiters and Seven Background, Sarah joined the Systems Alliance military, which was continuing its search for Prothean technology. Prothean technology. After successful discoveries on Mars, initially assigned to peacekeeping duties, Sarah was approached to serve a support role for these Prothean researchers. She often describes the thrill of serving with scientists like Mathis Silva on the brink of the next great discovery. When Alec Reiter was dishonorably discharged due to his AI research, that sucks. Internal memos show that this also effectively ended Sarah's career, but Andromeda presented the kind of scientific frontiers she has sought all her life. On arrival in Andromeda, Sarah's cryopod was damaged and her revival process interrupted. Dr. Lexi Tapiro advised keeping her in medically induced coma to allow her awaken naturally. All right. That's a lot of times I hit escape.
Keep them in the pod for now. Round-the-clock monitoring. We don't know if they're in true stasis anymore.
Right.
So that sucks.
The body could be waking up.
But others aren't. We can't be sure just yet.
Hopefully that gets fixed. All right, let me change my sensitivity real quick. Gameplay. Not gameplay controls. Mod sensitivity. Like I said earlier, I had to put it down really low because I had to uninstall my Corsair utility and it was messing with my sensitivity. There we go. Okay. What's down this way? Okay, these are more cryopads. Cryopods. I have to hold it.
Still in stasis. Vitals look good.
Alright, so that person's fine. Is this one fine as well? Probably.
Another colonist here.
How do you mean?
I'm guessing that's fine. This is a lot of people are in here. These are all cryopods. Wow. Okay. So I went and checked on my sister. I got that out of the way. That optional one. Let's go. Oh, data pad. Attention Hyperion personnel, after a 600-year voyage, the good news is we're exactly where we're supposed to be. We have arrived in the Halesis Cluster, Andromeda Galaxy, year 2819. See, I said 2885, I think I said. Or no, I said 2785. It says 600 years, but I guess it's been a little more 2819. All Stasis medical personnel should report for duty immediately. Give the Pathfinder mission team revival priority and prep its members for field reconnaissance. Reports of an unusual celestial phenomenon in the cluster are being investigated. Updates will follow. Captain Dunn. Fisher.
Morning, Ryder. Or afternoon? Or I don't know.
All right, that was informational.
Suit up and get ready to go.
Kirkland.
Good to see you, Ryder. Sorry, still waiting for some coffee.
I have my coffee, and you can't have any. Yes, you're a very long way from home.
All right,
so open door.
What's wrong?
Whoa, I was gonna say, who's over here? That's not good. Alright, so the explosion over there.
Up here! Whatever hit the arc fried everything. We have to balance the power loader and explode.
But we don't know where the fault is.
Ryder could find it. He has a scanner. Quick, Ryder, use it to locate the fault. On it.
I'll try to get readings.
All right, so G, open my scanner.
Hayward, get
G.
On it. I'll override the safeties.
Oh, okay, that's kind of weird. Scan highlighted objects.
There's no indication of a fault in this component.
Keep.
Relay 2C shows damage from a temperature spike.
Found it. Bad relay. Ryder.
G to exit scan. Over here. Sure. Because I know how to do everything. I am the technology expert on this. Let me just face it. There we go.
There. It's reset.
Do it. We're routing the current now.
It's working.
Readings are in the green.
Thank God. That could have been the end of everyone in the cryo bay.
Oh. Looks like I'm the hero. I just
Good
saved
job,
everybody.
Ryder. Now we can get to the tram.
All right. So head to the tram. And another door. Alright. You got some plants in here.
Barely an Andromeda, and we're already scrambling.
The adventure begins.
Yeah,
I'm
it wouldn't
sure
be.
Your dad'll see it that way.
It wouldn't be as fun if
go
it was
ahead and take
steady.
Us to the bridge.
Anything in here before I go? No. Really nice tram, though. Alright. So let's go ahead and go to the bridge.
Comm control, report. We're drifting.
Flight controls aren't responding.
First priority is stopping these outages.
Mainline power's been knocked out. We're on reserves, Captain. They won't last.
What's our position?
Unknown. We lost telemetry.
Sam, we need eyes out there.
Attempting to adjust sensor array.
Alec, please. You may be Pathfinder, but this is my ship.
Captain, the protocol's clear. In the absence of communication with the Nexus or the other Arcs, we proceed to our appointed Golden World. Solid ground.
If it's even out there. Nobody said anything about running into an energy cloud, and that's just a wild guess what we hit.
I guess they changed his skin to match
Alec,
more
I
of my skin.
Alec, I need to assess the damage. Stop the bleeding. We've got 20,000 people asleep on this ship. Let's give them a chance to wake up.
Can you blame her?
See, I prefer solid ground. I do prefer solid ground, or it's her call. Let's go with... It's
she
her call.
She is the captain. I think she gets the final word.
Well, he might.
This isn't about having the final word.
Yes, sir. We're coming through.
He wasn't too happy with that choice.
My
oh, well.
God. Is that our golden world?
That's Habitat 7. New Earth, if we're lucky. All of our long-range scans told us it was in the green zone. Perfect for human settlement.
It doesn't even look the same.
We can't give up now. It looks bad. Now, see, this is the kind of the emotional ones that I said. We cannot give up now.
We don't know how bad it is yet. Still seems like it's our best shot.
Maybe. There's just a lot on the line.
Sam?
The energy from the phenomenon is damping our senses. Planetary conditions are unknown.
That looks pretty bad to me. It looks pretty bad.
We're marooned. 20,000 souls adrift at sea. And when the power runs out and stays out, we need to know if that's safe harbor.
And if it's not?
As Pathfinder, it'll be my job to find an alternative. It's what we trained for. But if this goes well, we are already home.
All right, just make it quick.
Harper, the rest of the team should be awake by now. Have them spin up two shuttles. Planet Fallen 30.
Yes, sir.
A stubborn one, isn't he?
I wouldn't know. That doesn't make sense for logical answer, since he is supposed my father. So I just have to go with give him a chance.
He cares in his own way. Enough to give him a chance.
I suppose you're right. He is our pathfinder. If this doesn't work out, we'll need him more than ever.
I need an ETA on our sensor repairs. We're blind out here.
This game looks so nice.
My sister's gonna hate that she missed this.
Are all the Riders adrenaline junkies?
I guess it's in her blood. She beat me into the world by 1 minute. Couldn't wait to get started.
Well, don't worry. I'm sure Sarah will pull through.
When she does, she's gonna want stories.
So, let's get out there and find her some.
This is the captain.
Right. You'll want to get your helmet. And maybe stop at the good luck rock before we go.
The what?
It's an old superstition of your dad's.
Oh, there's a data pad right there. Hold on. Let's check out the codex real quick. See the Andromeda Initiative. We've got something else in here. Oh, okay, so we have Alec Ryder. Born on Earth. This guy, he's the father. He was the one who was dishonorably discharged. Cora Harper. Lieutenant Cora Harper, service number 6002-AC-1762, is a human biotic. Okay, I did not know that. And formerly an officer in the Systems Alliance military. Alright. A subset of their high levels, test scores spike abnormally high levels. She was transferred via the Citadel Council's Valkyrie program. For Alec Ryder as second in command, if warranted, his successor as Pathfinder. Okay. Then Dr. Ellen Ryder. Ellen Ryder, formerly known as Harlow, was a pioneer designer of biotic implants. I'm guessing this is... Yeah, this is our mother. Ellen met Alec Ryder when he was posted to Rio for ICT and 7 training before the First Contact War. Alright. In her final years, Ellen Ryder built what would later become the Pathfinder implants designed to sync with the AI partner Alec Ryder was developing. Ellen died before my creation was fully realized. Okay. And then there is something else in here. Oh, the initiative. Golden Worlds. Habitats 1 through 7, while not generally used in planetary surveying, the term Golden World was coined by Andromeda Initiative's marketing team and has stuck ever since. Basically, what Golden World means is it will support life. Okay, so planets and locations. Unknown phenomena right here. As you already have clear understanding of this phenomena. And then we have technology. Exploration tools. Scanner. We can scan things. And check them out. Let's go ahead and get this data pad. Introduction. As a member of the Pathfinder team, you play a critical role in Andromeda Initiative's efforts to establish a foothold in the new galaxy. The team faces many challenges. Golden World site verification, reconnaissance, and mapping of unknown territories, planetary and celestial. Scientific analysis and discovery of new phenomenon. Potential first contact with extraterrestrials. Establishing diplomatic relations with local inhabitants. And general support of settlement outposts. Sounds easy enough, right? Let's see, get my helmet.
We scanned Andromeda. Everything was in the clear.
How could things change like that?
My sisters?
Hang in there, Sarah.
I see some purple bottles. Not getting to see anything else. Alright, my dad's locker.
Looks like dad's already suited up.
Yep, he's ready. You could tell that he's already in the suit. Fisher!
Ryder?
Did you get your coffee yet?
Fisher, how's it going?
I heard
heard a rumor from the bridge that your dad and the captain aren't seeing eye to eye on this.
I don't believe the rumors.
I don't know what that's about.
Okay, then. I'll just pretend I didn't hear that you took Gunn's side.
More rumors.
Maybe, but I figure at the end of the day, the Pathfinder team answers to the Pathfinder. Besides, your dad's the N7 here. He's got the best aim. I go wherever he goes.
Why is my mouse on the screen?
Okay. I got it.
Oh, there he goes. Okay, that was weird. Kirkland and Greer.
Hey, Ryder.
It's Kirkland, right?
Yeah. I think we met just before the Hyperion left Earth. Not sure if you know Greer.
Hi there. Your dad say anything about what's going on?
Sensors are scrambled. Potentially a pinfall in 30. Be afraid. Be very, very afraid. Pinfall in 30.
He was all business. Told us to prep and be ready to go.
Short and sweet, huh? Will do.
See you guys on the ride down.
Deactivate. Oh. Everyone needs a little music before they go. Alright, let's get my helmet on.
Got it.
The Pathfinder is now requiring sidearms. I've opened the armaments locker.
We expecting trouble, Sam?
Oh, there we go.
In precaution, please arm yourself, Ryder.
Let's go ahead and take a gun.
You never know.
Ooh, data pad, okay. First contact protocol. In the event any member of the Pathfinder team encounters intelligent alien life, it is imperative that first contact protocols be strictly observed. The Andromeda Initiative holds the principles of peace and cooperation among our highest ideals. Aggressive action against extraterrestrials is only permitted when hostile intent is clearly demonstrated, and Pathfinder team members are at obvious risk of injury or death. So don't shoot unless you get shot at first. Okay? And here's the rock.
Good luck, Rock, huh?
Your dad was mountain climbing back on Earth. It caught him from falling.
Analysis indicates alkali feldspar and quartz, commonly known as granite.
Okay, so piece of granite. That's our... Oh, hello. Okay. Water cooler, data pad. I read that already. All right. Let's go ahead. Let's talk to Cora real quick.
So just another boring day at the office, huh?
I can't wait to get out there. The nap wasn't long enough. We can handle it, or no plan is perfect. We can handle it.
I figure it's a chance to show everyone what we can do. Go out there and earn our stripes.
You're Alex's son, all right. I always wondered what it was like when explorers crossed the ocean. Nothing but stars and dead reckoning to guide them.
And a map that said, here be dragons.
Well, if they made it, we can too. And maybe see a dragon along the way.
Let's hope.
Never know. Let's keep an eye out.
And our distance.
On that note, time to get to the shuttle.
All right. Something was completed.
Dr. Carlyle, with everything going on, I think the Ark needs you more than we do.
Pathfinder wants a medic on hand, and if that is home down there, I'm happy to knock on the door.
You and me both, or this could get rough. This could get rough.
Yeah, we're just not sure what's on the other side of the door.
No problem. If it has teeth, I brought the pliers. Yank them out myself.
Isn't he a little cocky?
All right, team, button it up. We leave in 5.
Sir, we broke out the weapons as requested. Anything we should know about?
Seem prudent given the situation. We'll be short-handed with Sarah out. I heard what happened. Your sister's strong. She'll make it.
Let's see, is she better? Or we shouldn't worry. We shouldn't worry.
Sarah wouldn't want us to worry because of her.
You're right. The mission comes first. Though, I doubt your mother would have seen it that way. I promised her I'd get you two here safely.
Technically, they're safe. She's okay, just still
team,
sleeping.
Listen up. I chose each of you for the Pathfinder team, not just because you're talented and passionate, but because you're dreamers, like me. We dream of exploring the unknown, finding the edge of the map, and then discovering what lies beyond. When people look back on this, and they will, they'll remember we didn't give up. That we kept dreaming that our first few faltering steps in Andromeda were the beginning of everything they know. We only get one chance to be first. So, let's go make history.
Been waiting 600 years for this.
All right. Let's start.
Archive area, this is Shuttle 1. Switching to manual guidance. Shuttle 2, taking your lead.
Good luck, Pathfinder team.
So it's been about 50 minutes, and we're finally getting off the Andromeda.
Turning to Vector 135.
Copy that. We're on point.
Wow, will you look at that?
Whatever it is, it stopped the Hyperion in its tracks.
It appears to be an unstable mass of dark energy.
If you say so,
steer clear of it.
This is a nice little, ship, a little crowded.
Gravity anomalies detected.
Ooh. Okay. Bye.
We're clear. Accelerating to cruising speed.
Ryder, we didn't have a chance to meet back in the Milky Way. Name's Liam Costa, security and response specialist.
Good to meet you, Liam.
Hard to believe we're finally doing this.
Sure beats reading the brochures.
Beginning our deceleration. Planet's dead ahead.
We got there pretty quickly. Seemed like we were further away than that, but oh well.
Hang on. Initiating atmospheric entry.
Here we go.
The flight guidance is scrambled. It'll pass. The controls are fighting me.
Adjust approach vector. 3-2.
We're through.
Holy.
Shuttle 2, are you seeing this?
Copy that. Doesn't look like a golden world from here.
No, not at all.
Stay on course to the landing zone.
Oxygen levels are below minimum human requirements.
Is this the right planet? We had this all worked out.
Keep it tight, Shuttle 2.
Mountains are floating.
That's not... Ooh, what is that?
That has to be advanced engineering.
Hyperion, this is the Pathfinder. We've got evidence of an alien civilization.
Has anyone
that's
seen
an understatement.
What if they're not friendly?
We stick to contact protocol. No use of deadly force unless hostile intent is clear.
Oh. Oh, that sucks. Oh, Liam's gone. Oh, I'm gone. Okay.
Acceleration increasing.
That seems like that could be bad right there.
Get it working.
Approaching terminal velocity.
Sam!
Oh. A little bit of a rough landing, but helm was cracked. Just use my trusty Omni tool and repair my glass. Yeah. Good as new. No cracks. That's weird. The glass in the helmet was kind of odd looking. And you're looking through it, but whatever. Wow.
This is Ryder. Come in. Hyperion, Sam,
Anyone there? Save your breath, Ryder. Sam's offline. Comlink's trashed. I'm surprised we aren't too.
Oh, hey, Liam was alive. So did that really happen, or any survivors?
Did the others make it? I don't know. It was all a blur. Shuttle split in two. This is like some nightmare.
Yeah. No way this is home.
If it is, that kind of sucks.